Tonight we're lucky enough to have Bruce Springsteen and Bonnie Raitt. Looks like we're running a little late, but everything's going to be okay. Direct from Asbury Park, Bruce Springsteen and the E Street Band.
I went to Barry's apartment, and I was played the second album, The Wild, the Innocent, and the E Street Shuffle, and I was totally blown away. I think I also played the first album, Greeting from Asbury Park. And, you know, they were just, to me, they were incredible albums. And after we spoke, he was playing at Joe's Place, so I went to see him there and was just blown away by the guy. And at that time, the Bonnie Raitt show at the Harvard Square Theater was already pretty much signed, sealed, and completed. And I went to Jeff and my brother and I said, listen, I saw this guy. This guy's incredible, Bruce Springsteen. You've got to come see him. I brought them to Joe's and we saw him. And then Jeff made the arrangements, you know, him being the guy with the inside, made the arrangements to talk. And we said, from those discussions, how would you like to be the opening act for Bonnie Raitt? And he said, great. And he gave me the name of his manager. That's who we contacted. And they said, yeah, we'll do it. And, you know, when is it? And it was two shows in one night. And I think if I recall, we paid him $500 for the whole E Street Band for two shows in one night. Originally, the show was already done. You know, Bonnie was going to, it was going to be a solo thing at the Harvard Square Theater, a nice small venue. We did not need an opening act, but I really insisted that do this because this guy was incredible. So I insisted with Jeff and my brother, we got to do this. And so they did. I was more into finding bands on their way up. And it was a history-making show. We gave, I think it was 10 or 15 tickets. And John Landau was one of the people that got a free ticket. He sat, I think it was in the eighth row. And of course, that's part, you know, that's John Landau wrote the review, had the quote lifted. And then John Landau became his personal manager. So. It was quite a concert, quite an event. It was his early band, David Sanchez, and Ernie Carter on drums. And those pictures that that were taken by Barry at the show were amazing pictures. Sitting there with that white hat, and looking how skinny he was. And they played their hearts out, and they blew the audience away. And you know, the rest. I mean, that's where the ball started rolling, I think. And, I got to meet him, you know, and know him, and I mean, he was a very nice, friendly guy, you know. And then we did Bruce Springsteen again. We're at the Music Hall, I think, with Dr. John, if I recall. That was right before he broke. He still wasn't a giant yet, and there's an interesting story that goes along with that concert. We called him up and said, can we have a new piece of music for a radio spot? Because nothing had come out since The Wild, the Innocent, and the E Street Shuffle. And he sent us a cassette tape of a song called Tramps Like Us. And that song was Born to Run. We got a demo tape and handed that over to WBCN to make a radio spot. And had that song on the radio before the album was even out. I mean, I know that in my small way, I'm not gonna say anything to do with him becoming famous, but you know, he would have become famous anyways. But it's great to know that I was there at the beginning.